Hello, in this session let us go through the derivation of Petrov's equation in case of hydrodynamic journal bearings. Next is the derivation of Petrov's equation for hydrodynamic journal bearings. So this is the case of lightly loaded journal bearings. So the person called Petrov did the analysis of the hydrodynamic bearings in 1883, and this equation is known as Petrov's equation and is used to predict the coefficient of friction in hydrodynamic journal bearings. So as you can see from the figure, we have a shaft or a journal of diameter small d, and which is surrounded by, and around this shaft we have the bearing or bushing, and the load acting is denoted by W. Petrov's equation basically gives us the coefficient of friction in case of lightly loaded journal bearings. So this phenomenon of the bearing friction was first explained by this person called Petrov. So it is based on the assumption that the journal is concentric with respect to the bearing, and let us consider shaft of a journal of radius small r rotating, which rotates inside this bearing, and whatever the clearance is there, it's completely filled with the oil. This will rotate with the speed n, and the clearance whatever is there that is filled with the oil of proper viscosity. Next is the assumptions in Petrov's equation. So as we can see from the figure, a journal is inside a sleeve or a bearing. Small r is the radius of the journal, and the clearance between these journal and bearing is completely filled with oil of proper viscosity. And it is assumed that the bearing carries very light loads, and Petrov's equation is actually applicable for lightly loaded bearings. And secondly, the journal is assumed to be concentric with the bearing, although this is not practically applicable, because this is possible only if the load will be very small, or if the viscosity of the lubricant is sufficiently high, and also the speed of the journal will be sufficiently high, then only we can assume that the journal is concentric with the bearing. So therefore, considering that the lubricant is having high viscosity and also the journal is rotating at high speeds or sufficient speeds so as to create the that oil film, so it is assumed that the journal is concentric with the bearing. Also, the viscosity of the oil is assumed to be high and remains constant throughout the oil film, and there is no variation of the viscosity of the oil. Also, the leakage is neglected. It's assumed that there is no leakage from the oil leakage from the bearing. Also, it's assumed that the oil film is thin, so that the whatever the curvature between the bearing and the journal is neglected, and the oil film may be considered as a prismatic one, as can be seen from the figure, having thickness equal to the radial clearance between the journal and the bearing. Next, coming to the terminology of the bearing, capital R represents the radius of the bearing, small r represents the radius of the journal, L denotes the length of the bearing, capital L, and tau refers to the shear stress in the oil or lubricant, and F suffix mu, F mu refers to the tangential friction force that is generated in the oil, and eta is represents the absolute or dynamic viscosity of the oil. The unit of the viscosity is given in Pascal seconds. W is the radial load that is acting on the journal, and C, as discussed earlier, the clearance, the diameter clearance between the bearing and the journal is indicated by C, whereas the radial clearance is indicated by CR. The radial clearance is given by the difference in the radii of the bearing and the journal, capital R minus small r. Now, in order to find out this frictional force in this bearing, or the whatever the frictional force that is generated whenever this shaft or journal starts rotating, there will be friction that is generated in the oil. So in order to find out this frictional force, that is given by the product of the shear stress tau in the oil and the area. This area is basically given by the area that of the journal, that is the product of pi d, that is the circumference, and the length of the bearing. So in order to find out this shear stress, we have from Newton's law of viscosity the shear stress tau given by the product of this absolute viscosity eta into u by h, where u represents the velocity of the journal, and h represents the whatever the clearance between the bearing and the journal on one side. So in our case, it is given by the radial clearance, CR. Next, coming to the equation, as seen in the previous slide, F mu, the frictional force given by the product of tau and area of the journal. So let us take it as equation number one. And Newton's law of viscosity equation, whatever we have taken, that is tau is equal to the product of eta into u over h. So here in this equation, u represents the velocity at the surface of the journal, which can be given by the expression pi dn over 60, where d is the diameter of the journal, n is the rpm of this journal. So this n by 60 is denoted by this term n dash. So velocity of the journal can be indicated by also by pi d n dash. So now here h, small h, represents the distance between the journal and the bearing, or the clearance between the journal and the bearing, and that corresponds to the radial clearance, CR, which is nothing but the diameter clearance divided by 2. Now area represents here the area of, in this equation number 1, the area of the journal surface. So that is the surface area. So that's why I told that is the area is given by the product of the pi d and whatever the length L of the journal. So substituting these things in equation number 1, it will give us F mu is equal to eta into u by h into A. So substituting in place of A, u and h, the respective expressions we have got, it will be given by F mu is given by eta into pi d n dash, which is nothing but the velocity, into area is given by pi d l, and h is given by the expression c by 2. which is nothing but the clearance. So this equation, if we simplify, then it will be given as 2 pi square neta n dash into L into d square divided by c. So we have a term called diameter clearance ratio, so which is defined as the ratio of the diameter clearance to the diameter of the journal, so indicated by psi. So if we use this in the above equation, then the above equation can be written as f mu is equal to 2 pi square neta n dash into ld divided by psi. So this gives us the expression for the frictional force in the journal bearing. So note that the ratio C by D is called diameter clearance ratio. So if we substitute for C by D, C is nothing but, it can be written as 2 times the radial clearance, and D can be written as 2R. So it can be given by the ratio of CR by R also, and that is called as radial clearance ratio. So frictional torque, in order to find out the frictional torque, so it can be given by the product of the frictional force and the radius of the journal, because force into radius gives the torque. So here we have already the expression for the friction force F mu given by the 2 pi square neta n dash into LD by psi. So into the radius of the journal is can be written as D by 2. So if we simplify this, so this 2 and 2 cancels, and it is given by pi square into neta into n dash into L into D square divided by psi. This gives the frictional torque in this journal bearing. So in order to find out the coefficient of friction, so we know that the coefficient of friction is given by the ratio of the frictional force to the load acting. So and also, as we discussed earlier, the average bearing pressure or the bearing pressure can be given by the expression or the ratio of the load acting on the bearing to the projected area of the bearing or the journal, that is projected area is given by the product L into D. So bearing pressure is P is equal to W by L into D. So if we substitute this in the above equation mu, we will get mu is equal to 2 pi square neta n dash by psi into LD into W is given by, W can be written as PDL, the product of this pressure and this projected area of the bearing. So it will become 1 by PDL here. So simplifying this, we will get the coefficient of friction as 2 pi square eta n dash. So this L and D will cancel over here. So what will be left in the denominator is the psi and P. So this is the expression that we get from the analysis of the equation for journal bearings.